Good evening all. This is video lecturing from Shivananda Sharma Memorial RV College, an ISR initiative. Welcome to video lectures. SSMRV College, one of the premier institutes run by the prestigious RV group of institution, has come up with a unique initiative to engage students at a time of this unforeseen medical emergency caused by corona outbreak. As a socially responsible institution, we would like to connect academically with students to make good the losses caused. In this connection, I, Shivakumara, Department of Commerce, has posted a video on the subject matter, management accounting, and the topic cash flow statement. Please watch the video till the end and like, share with your peer groups and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you. Good evening all. I, Shivakumaran, Department of Commerce, have prepared the PPT and as well as the video lectures on the topic cash flow statement. In this video lectures, I have covered the meaning of cash, cash equivalents, cash flow statement, and the activities such as operating activities, financing activities, and financing activities of cash flows. And please go through the entire video lectures and please share in the peer groups and subscribe our YouTube channel. Thank you. Cash plays a very important role in the entire economic life of a business. A firm needs cash to make a payment to its suppliers and to incur day-to-day expenses and to pay salaries, wages, interest, dividend, etc. So it is like a blood in any human body. Cash is to a business and enterprises. It is very essential for a business to maintain an economic balance of cash, but many a times a concern operates profitably and yet it becomes very difficult to pay taxes and dividend. Cash flow statement is a statement which describes the inflow, the resources and the outflows, that are uses of the cash and cash equivalents in an enterprise during a specified period of time. Information about the cash flows of an enterprise is useful in providing users of financial statements with a basis to assess the ability of the enterprises to generate cash and cash equivalents and the needs of the enterprises to utilize those cash flows. The economic decisions that are taken by the users require an evaluation of the ability of an enterprise to generate cash and cash equivalents and the timing and certainty of their generation. The statement deals with the provision of information about the historical changes in cash and cash equivalents of an enterprise by means of a cash flow statement, which classified cash flows during the period of from operating, investing, and financing activities. Let us know the meaning of cash, cash equivalents, and cash flows in the cash flow statement. Cash comprises cash on hand and demand deposits with banks. Cash equivalents are short-term, highly liquid investments that are readily convertible into known amounts of cash and which are subject to an insignificant risk of changes in value. Cash equivalents are held for the purpose of meeting short-term cash commitments rather than for the investment or other purposes. For an investment to qualify as a cash equivalent, it must be readily convertible to a known amount of cash, be subject to an insignificant risk of change in value. Therefore, an investment normally qualifies as a cash equivalent only when it has a short maturity of say 3 months or less than from the date of acquisition. Cash flows are inflows and outflows of cash and cash equivalents. Flow of cash is said to have taken place when any transaction makes changes in the amount of cash and cash equivalents available for happening of the transaction. So I already mentioned cash flows or inflows and outflows of cash and cash equivalents. The flow of cash is said to have taken place when and any transaction makes changes in the amount of cash and cash equivalents available before happening of the transaction. If the effect of transaction result in the increase of cash and its equivalents, it is called an inflow, that is the limited sources. And at the same time, If it results in the decrease of total cash, it is known as outflow or nothing but a uses of cashes. Uses of cash. So classification of cash flows according to Indian Accounting Standard 7, existingly that is Accounting Standard 3, the cash flow statement should report cash flows during the period of classified as follows: cash flows from operating activities, cash flows from investing activities, cash flows from financing activities. Cash flows from operating activities. Operating activities are the principal revenue producing activities of the enterprises and other activities that are not investing or financing activities. The amount of cash flows arising from the operating activities is a key indicator of the extent to which the operations of the enterprises have generated sufficient cash flows to maintain the operating capability of the enterprises, pay dividends, repay loans, and make new investments without resource to external source of financing. Information about the specific components of historical operating cash flows is useful in conjunction with other information in forecasting future operating cash flows. Cash flows from operating activities are primarily derived from the principal revenue producing activities of the enterprises. Therefore, they generally result from the transaction and other events that enter into the determination of net profit or net loss. Examples of cash flows from the operating activities, even from non-financial companies, are also as follows: cash received from the sale of goods and the rendering services, cash received from the royalties, fees, commission and other revenue, cash payment to suppliers of goods and services, cash payment to and on behalf of employees, cash receipts and cash payments of an insurance enterprises for premiums and claim annuities and other policy benefits, so etc. Investing activities are the acquisition and the disposal of long-term assets and other investments not included in cash equivalents. The separate disclosure of cash flows arising from the investing activities is important because the cash flows represent to the extent which expenditure have been made for resources intended to generate future income and cash flows. Some of the examples of cash flows arising from investing activities are cash payments to acquire fixed assets including intangibles. These payments include those relating to the capitalized research and development cost and self-constructed fixed assets. Cash receipts from disposal of fixed assets including intangible assets. Cash payments to acquire shares, warrants and debt instruments. Then cash advances and loans. Cash receipts from the repayment of advances and loans. Cash payments for future contracts, forwards, contracts, options contracts and swap contracts. Then cash received from the future contracts, forward contracts, option contracts and swap contracts, etc. Financing activities are activities that result in changes in the size and composition of owner's capital, including preference share capital in the case of a company and borrowings of the enterprises. The separate disclosure of cash flows arising from financing activities is important because it is useful in predicting claims on future cash flows by providers of funds, both capital and borrowings, to the enterprises. Some of the examples of cash flows arising from financing activities are cash proceeds from issuing shares or other similar instruments, cash proceeds from issuing debentures, loans, notes, bonds, and other short or long-term borrowings, and cash payments of amounts borrowed, such as redemption of debentures, bonds, preference shares, etc.
This small topic clear for you. Thank you for watching. Like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Thank you, and watch out for our new video lectures again. Thank you so much.